Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of Great Locks. I'm Gunther the Great, and today I'm answering another question from one of you guys. So today's question is from, I don't even know how to say the name, EBKEJ. So he asked, I'm trying to start freeform locks. Do you have any tips? The thing about freeform locks, it's different for everybody, and at the same time, it's not different for everybody. So what I mean by that is everybody's hair locks at a different rate. So if you have a one hair type, which is completely straight hair, versus a 4C hair type, which is the tightest curl pattern, 4C hair type is gonna lock up a whole lot easier than one. And this works for every hair type. 4C is always gonna lock up a little bit quicker and a little bit better than one. But it doesn't mean that you can't maintain the one to make it look like 4C locked up. But what I mean by that is using a method called instant locking or using a crochet hook to actually maintain the hair to look like it's tight curl pattern in order to lock up the hair. But I actually explained that in the Great Locks Masterclass, and if you guys do want that, link is down below if it's out already. I'm not sure if it's out yet, but it is releasing real soon. But tips on getting freeform locks. Freeform, unfortunately, for a lot of you guys who came to this video and want a actual tutorial on how to do it, it is simply put, it's allowing your hair to freely form. That's why it's called freeform. It's not twisting with gel, it's not twist and rip, it's not interlocking, it's not crochet hooking, it's not instant locking, it's not any of those methods, because it's allowing your hair to freely form. So you have to consider, can straight hair freely form? Of course it can, but it's gonna take quite some time, and it's not gonna look the way you imagined freeform hair to look. It'll look a little bit more messy, the tips will be frayed, and of course it'll take longer for it to actually lock up. Versus 4C hair, then it'll lock up pretty quick. If you don't maintain and you neglect your hair at 4C, it's gonna lock up pretty fast. Now, if your hair is somewhere in the middle, say you have like a 3A, maybe 3B or 3C, if you're in the three ranges, then it's gonna lock up somewhere in the middle between 1 and 4C. So if you have a 3A, it's probably gonna lock up within the next 2 to 4 months. But with 4C hair type, it's gonna lock up within maybe 1 to 2 months. And all it takes is literally these two things, washing and drying. You don't have to do anything with your hands. You don't have to do any methods or any rubber bands or any tools or any products. You don't have to do any of those things. All it takes is patience and washing and drying. And I'm not even saying drying with a towel, just allowing it to air dry. Now, of course, when your hair becomes mature, you want to dry it quickly because you don't want water to sit inside of your dreadlocks. Water sitting in your dreadlock can eventually create mold, and nobody wants that inside their hair, of course. But I know you're probably a little bit disappointed on the answer, how to get freeform locks. Washing and drying, but it's really as simple as that. And I'm telling you, it's gonna look the best if you just follow that step of washing and drying your hair. It may not seem like it's gonna work, but that's really how it goes. If you have a curl to your hair, say you have a 3A, maybe to 4C, then those curls that are on your hair will eventually pair up with other curls, and that eventually will lock up, become a lock. And then after that, there's gonna be locks besides locks, and those locks will combine. And it's really just a downhill slope from there of creating locks, and it's a snowball effect. Once one starts locking, then they all start locking. And once there's an initial lock, then it locks really fast. So it's really just being patient and allowing your hair to lock up. And of course, there are ways to make your hair look like it's freeform locks. And that's using, you know, a sponge rub or a towel rub, and then eventually just allowing it to lock up on its own. Or you use other methods, what people call semi-freeform. Say they start out with twisting with gel, and then they allow it to initially lock up. And then after that, they allow their hair to freeform afterward. So it's really up to you. But if you just want to do freeform, then wash your hair and let it dry, and then in a couple months, see where your hair is at, and believe me, it will lock up eventually. Because it's really inevitable that if you do not comb through your hair, any hair type is going to lock up. It's bound to be. But if you do want to learn more about this, make sure to ask me questions down below. Other than that, make sure to go pick up the locking bundle. If you do want to get maintained or methodized dreadlocks, then pick up the locking bundle, because it's going to help you instantly lock up your hair if you want to do the method route. And when I say instant, I really mean instant. I've done someone's full head of dreadlocks in less than 5 hours, and you can do your own hair as well. I've done my own head in less than a day. You can literally start and finish your dreadlocks in one day and have them fully mature and washing your hair that same day if you wanted to. So make sure to pick that up. It is on sale right now. And also, do not forget to go follow the Great Locks Instagram page. It's really a community and a family of all these people that have different sets of dreadlocks, different ethnicities, different colors, and all kinds of different styles and methods on how they got their dreadlocks. So it's really cool to see that. So make sure to go follow Great Locks on Instagram, and also tag us so you can be featured. But other than that, guys, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.